at 9:07 p.m. at the White House, and I printed this picture. This is from CNN. This is a live shot. This is President Donald Trump. On one side is Clarence Thomas, a black Supreme Court justice. On the other side is ACB, Amy Coney Barrett, a female, well, not at this, at the taking of this photo, but soon to be Supreme Court justice. A woman, an African-American, Donald Trump in the middle, a racist misogynist, I just like to point out. But the interesting thing about the CNN clip about the live swearing in of ACB by Clarence Thomas is the chyron, which is the lower third, is what they write at the bottom. And of course they write, Trump's Supreme Court nominee about to be sworn in. But instead of stopping it there, they write underneath, at White House, at another potential super spreader event. I kid you not. This historic moment when Amy Coney Barrett becomes another woman to sit on the bench to replace Ruth Bader Ginsburg, being sworn in by Clarence Thomas, the third Supreme Court justice selected and confirmed by President Donald Trump, and CNN writes, Trump's Supreme Court nominee about to be sworn in at the White House at another potential super spreader event. They had to put potential in there because nobody got COVID-19 yesterday, as far as we know. But they're not the only ones. This is the new thing. They now are not just accusing Donald Trump of doing nothing to keep the coronavirus out of this country. They're not just out there saying Donald Trump has been a horrible manager of this crisis. They're not just out there saying Donald Trump knew about the coronavirus. He knew how deadly it was. He knew how it could be transmitted via the air, and he didn't say a word about it. They didn't just say Donald. Now, they used to just go, Donald Trump told you to inject bleach into your veins, which he never did. Donald Trump called Dr. Fauci an idiot. Donald Trump is so reckless when it comes to coronavirus. That's not just what they're saying now. Now, they are also accusing him of being a super spreader of the coronavirus. They did it on CNN, and yesterday at an impromptu rally, quote unquote, that Joe Biden had to hold because he realized Donald Trump was walloping him. He realized that keeping a lid on his campaign may keep him safe from coronavirus, but is going to keep him out of the White House. So they had to throw together these events. And here he is talking about Donald Trump. Listen to what he says about Trump rallies.
To be traveling, continue to travel. But the big difference between us and reason why it looks like we're not traveling, we're not putting on super spreaders.
All right. So Joe Biden is saying, Donald Trump, you know, it may not look like we're getting out there because we're not, but we are. We're getting out there. But the difference between me and Donald Trump is I put together these really small, socially distanced, mask wearing press conference. Donald Trump puts on super spreaders. Not rally. They're not political rallies. They're super spreaders.
We're not putting on super spreaders.
Super spreaders. So today, Donald Trump has three super spreaders in three different states, and he's not the only one. CNN saying anytime Donald Trump does anything, because again, with this picture, Clarence Thomas and Amy Coney Barrett and Donald Trump are fairly spread apart. And yes, there's an audience. But anytime Donald Trump does something now, it's just a super spreader, because not only is he to blame for the coronavirus coming into this country, is he to blame for 200,000 deaths instead of what was originally predicted, 2 million deaths, which would be a sad win, but a win in anyone's book when it comes to keeping this virus at bay. Not only that, not only is he pushing forward a vaccine, working with several companies, signing deals with Walmart and CVS, and using the military to make sure when we do get a vaccine, it gets out there super gosh darn quick and protects the elderly and protects those with comorbidities and makes sure that people that really need it get it first. Not only is he doing that, but now he's the reason that it's spreading. I'll tell you what, I've been to a lot of Trump rallies, and I will tell you this. They are super spreaders. They are definitely super spreaders. When you go to a Trump rally, you are going to get super spread with love of country. You're going to get super spread with great ideas. You're going to get super spread with the importance of capitalism. They super spread information about socialism that you're not getting anywhere else. You're not getting it in your school system. You're not getting it from the media. They super spread the truth. Donald Trump, Joe Biden is right. He's not putting on super spreaders.
We're not putting on super spreaders.
No, because when you go to a Joe Biden quote unquote rally, you're getting nothing but lies. No, of course I won't ban fracking. No, of course I won't pack the court. Well, I may, but you know what? You're not even going to know the truth till after the election because you don't deserve to know. Vote for me, and then you'll find out if I'm packing the court. At a Donald Trump rally, it's a super spreader. They are super spreading the truth about Joe Biden, about Hunter Biden, about his economic plans with China and Russia. They're super spreading the truth about what AOC and Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi have planned for the court system. They're super spreading the truth about what's going to happen to your health care and how it's going to skyrocket. They're super spreading the truth about Joe Biden's tax plan, which means everybody's going to get a tax increase, not just the people making over $400,000 a year. Everybody going to suffer. The Boston Herald just this morning, they wrote a big long piece saying we have to support Donald Trump because Joe Biden's economic plan is devastating to the United States economy. It will put us into the biggest depression we've ever had, especially coming out of COVID-19. So yeah, Donald Trump's events are super spreaders of the truth.